Hi, it's Teresa Alsop here. We are coming to you from St. George at the Sony Quilting Center, and we are working on my great grandma Woggins quilt. We are ready to do the border, and I'm going to show you some cool tricks on the post-stitcher and some other tools that we can use to help accomplish our quilting of our quilt. So what we're going to do is this is kind of an irregular quilt. We've talked about this already, and our borders aren't too bad, actually. We do have a little bit of sweepiness that because of our especially like this one, you can see that it concaves in, and this one a lot. And so we have to kind of deal with those. We aren't going to build a regular border, so we are going to build one. It's called dead ending. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do an area and keep this little block, and we'll put another design right in here, because then it will just help it make it look like it's squared. And then we're going to quilt a design into here and then do a design right here in our end of our block. And that's dead end. And then we'll take this design when we're all done, we'll flip the quilt, put it back onto our frame and stitch the length here. And we'll do that in a, upcoming video. So some of the tools that I'm using are this glow in the line tape by OmniGrid. You can also use masking tape or frog tape, but this is just really easy little tape that sticks on and comes off. And so I don't know if you can see this or not. We'll come down to the cream so you can see this little orange tape. It comes in three different colors, and I pulled off an orange piece so I can see it. So I'm also using this edge of the round circle. See, it's a I'm using that as a guide. So I want my border to be in a little bit from, so it's not quite to the edge of this. And then up here on the top of my border, that's why I put my tape there, is because I want to have enough room for a binding plus a little bit so that it won't be covered up with my, when I put my binding on. And that's why I put that tape on there so I could see. So what I've done already, so that it doesn't take so long, is I went into my area and I plotted out using multi-point my complete border that I'm doing, that's not including the dead-ended square that we'll do later on. So I'm going to use this to be my border, and this is going to be in my dead-end square. Some of the tools that I use when I'm plotting things out are on here, are part of your tablet. So this is Home Refresh. It brings everything onto the screen so we can see it. And this is a one-to-one or a magnifying glass is like what I like to look at it. And it makes it so that I can see it really easily. So if I have my design right here, I can actually go to my magnifying glass and then follow where the mama duck and baby duck are, and then I can see exactly where I'm at. So for right now, we're going to be going back to Home Refresh, and here is my design that I picked, and I went in and picked Fulton Feathers block number 2, and that is in our Designs by Handy Quilter. And I'm going to repeat this design, move that one out of the way. So I'm going to go to repeat, and over here, I want to repeat my design horizontally. You notice this one's grayed out. That's because I touched this other design that is open on my side. And so I'm going to touch that to select it. And I'm just going to, in my repeat box, there's a plus or minus, and I'm going to add repeats, and it's a little bit big. So we're gonna just repeat it across the top and see how much. And I need about a little extra. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to stretch it horizontally so that it will fit in my block this way. And then I'm gonna go vertically and stretch it, and it will, and it looks a little bit ski-wompy. So we are going to unstretch it by hitting undo. And I didn't plot this out before, so we're just kind of playing with it. And now I'm going to try, we're going to go into modify and skew
and see how that makes it look. And it's a little bit better. It's still got a little bit of thickness to it. So what we can do is go ahead and do, go into repeat. We're going to undo so that it brings it back to, so that it looks a little more even. And we are going to go into, let's see what we want to do with it. We've got to decide how we're going to play with it so that it doesn't look so ski-wompy. So we're going to undo a little bit more. And so then I have that little space there. So now I'm going to go back into repeat. I'm going to add one more. Oh, not vertically, but horizontally. And now I need to crop off this half of my design, because otherwise I'm not going to like it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into Pro Stitcher, because that's where our new end and new start is. And we're going to use our end to back up. So we're going to go to right here and we're going to back this up. And let's go ahead and modify, do magnifying and follow so you can see what's happening on screen. So you can see my little end point that's represented with the circle. I'm using this to back it up so that I can go and crop off half of my design. So it's backing up that end point. So we're getting a little bit closer. I'm touching on the green so it makes bigger jumps. Now that I'm a little closer, I'm going to go to the arrow. So I can go down to this point right here, and I'm going to crop off that end. So I'm going to go to modify, crop, and see, we're going to do the start and end point right here. And it's not working for me. Okay, let's see. I don't know why it's not doing it.